In this video, I'll be doing mole conversion practice problems. I'm going to do these four problems. This video is really just practice problems, so before you watch it, you should feel comfortable with what the definition and a concept of a mole is. And if you need a more detailed explanation of the concepts behind these two conversions, I have two other videos which really go in depth and explain why we're doing every single step. In this video, I'm just going to go ahead and do the steps. So number one, how many molecules are there in 8.352 mole of H2SO4? So we need to identify our start and our finish to know what conversions we're going to have to do. Our start is what we're given, 8.352 mole. Our finish is what we're asked for, so how many molecules. This is our finish because once we have how many molecules, we're finished with the problem. And now we can go ahead and connect the arrow taking us from start to finish. We can see we're going to have to multiply by Avogadro's number. Setting up my number of moles and setting up Avogadro's number. And we always want to use units for Avogadro's number. The units are always going to be the number of particles per mole, and in this case, molecules are our particles. Now canceling out and multiplying. And our units are molecules of H2SO4. I used 3 Sig Figs because we had 4 from our number of moles, and we had 3 from Avogadro's number. So your teacher may or may not expect you to use Sig Figs with Avogadro's number, but it is technically a measurement, so it does have Sig Figs. And so this was our limiting factor in this case, so I was allowed to have 1, 2, 3 Sig Figs for my final answer. Next, I'm going to answer, how many grams are there in 7 moles of C4H8? So as always, getting our start and our finish. We were given moles, that's our start. We were asked for grams, that's our finish. So we're going to have to follow this arrow and multiply by the molar mass. So that means that our first step is just to get the molar mass of this molecule. So filling in using the atomic weights and how many of each element I have in my molecule. I get 56.108. My units are grams per mole. And in this case, we have a limitation of 1 Sig Fig from this 7. So when I'm calculating my molar mass, I just want to make sure that the atomic weights I'm pulling in from the periodic table have more Sig Figs than I have in my problem. So in this case, I used 4 and 5 Sig Figs. I only have 1 Sig Fig overall, so this works out. And now I'm going to go ahead and do my conversion. I'm going to multiply by the molar mass. Grams is on top, moles is on bottom. Canceling out moles, I can see I'm going to end up in grams. That's what I want. I get 392.756 grams, but remember, I only have 1 Sig Fig. So I'm limited to 400 with no decimal point grams of C4H8. Next, I'm asked, how many grams are there in 3.26 times 10 to the 25 molecules of Al2O3? So I'm given my number of particles, that's my start. I'm asked for the number of grams, this is my finish. And this is my first two-step conversion problem. All that means is that I have to first convert from number of particles to moles by dividing by Avogadro's number. Then I'll have moles, which will be my halfway point. And then to get to grams, I'll have to multiply by the molar mass. All right, so step one is just to divide my number of particles by Avogadro's number. And so instead of setting it up like division, I'm going to set it up by multiplying by the reciprocal of Avogadro's number. So that means that 6.02 times 10 to the 23 goes down here. And for our units, that gets flipped as well. So we have molecules down here and moles up here. Now I can see a little bit more clearly how my canceling out works. Molecules cancels, I'm going to end up in moles. And I end up with 54.153 mole Al2O3. Again, not caring about Sig Figs right now, I'm not done with my problem. Now I'm going to take this halfway number and go ahead and convert it into grams. And that means I'm going to have to calculate my molar mass. So not being careful with Sig Figs, just making sure that since I have 3 from the number of particles I was given, that I calculate a molar mass that has over 3 Sig Figs. And now I can go ahead and multiply my number of moles by my molar mass. Moles is going to cancel out. I'm going to end up in grams. I got 5,521.48. Now checking for sig figs, I have 3 from my original number. And I also have 3 from using Avogadro's number. So rounding this to have 3 sig figs, I get 5,520 grams of Al2O3. No decimal point. I want to make sure I only have 3 sig figs. And now, how many fluorine atoms are there in 90.25 grams of calcium fluoride? My start is the number of grams. My finish is the number of atoms. So I'm going to have to do 2 conversions. I'm going to have to first divide by the molar mass, ending up in the halfway point of moles. Then I'm going to have to multiply by Avogadro's number to end up with my number of particles. And I'll talk about this when I get to that point, but I also have an additional complication here because I was asked how many fluorine atoms, and this is giving me number of molecules. So my first step will be to calculate the number of molecules I have, and my second step will be to calculate how many fluorine atoms do I have within my calcium fluoride molecules. So step number 1 is to divide by the molar mass, which means once again, I have to have the molar mass. So my molar mass is 78.074 grams per mole. And now I can go ahead and divide my number of grams by my molar mass. And again, I'm going to go ahead and show you what it's like to multiply by the reciprocal of the molar mass instead of just dividing it, so we can see the units cancel out. So our number in grams goes down here, moles goes on top, cancel out grams. And without caring about sig figs, I get 1.15595 mole. Now I can take my halfway point answer and do my next conversion, which is to multiply by Avogadro's number. So I can see that my moles will cancel out. And my units right now is going to be in molecules. And the reason it's still molecules is because I used the molar mass of my entire molecule. I calculated the molar mass of calcium fluoride, so that's still what I'm dealing with. I'm going to go ahead and find the number of molecules before I deal with the fact that I was asked to find how many fluorine atoms we have. So my number of molecules is 6.9589 times 10 to the 23rd. And now to find the final answer, how many fluorine atoms I have, let's just think about this for a quick second. So every calcium fluoride molecule looks like this. So every single molecule has 2 fluorines. So even though we have this many molecules, we're going to have more fluorine atoms. And so you can think about this in terms of people. If you have 3 people, you're going to have 6 legs. So no matter how many people you have, you're always going to have more legs than you do people. And so that's just like this. We have 6.9589 times 10 to the 23rd molecules, and we're going to have times 2 of that, how many atoms? So that equals 1.40 times 10 to the 24th fluorine atoms. And for sig figs, I had 4 from my original number. I had 3 from pulling in Avogadro's number, and then I made sure that I calculated a molar mass that had more than 3 and 4 sig figs, so that didn't contribute to my sig figs in any way. All right, hope this video was useful, and as always, happy studying. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around, and watch my other tutorials, and as always, happy studying.